Hey everybody, welcome back. Today we're going to talk pools and iron. Alright, so it's been real busy here around the house. We just put in an above ground pool for the kids, just a 16 foot by 48 inches. And I soon discovered that once we filled it up, we had iron in our water. We're on well water here at the Bearded Hobbits, or the Hobbit Hole. And when I filled up the pool, I noticed it wasn't very clear water. It had kind of a brownish tint to it. So I hopped online, kind of started reading up on iron in the water. I've never had a pool before, so this is kind of all new to me. And this is what I discovered on how to kind of get iron out of your water. So you've got a couple different options. Number one, you don't get it out. There is some chemicals you can purchase that will basically keep your iron suspended. And by doing so, that prevents rust, kind of corrosion, all kinds of issues that you get with iron. Mainly staining, not rust, but staining. But I wasn't looking for that solution. My solution that I was looking for was, how do I get iron out of the pool, just out of the water? Now, the water was fine to swim in. It just looked a little bit brown. Kids don't care. But, you know, I wanted to have nice, clean water. So the other things that I found on the internet were this. Number one, to get the iron out, you can get some stuff, some chemicals, to cause the iron to settle out. And the way that this works is you turn off, you mix the chemical in there. I believe it's a flocculant. Don't quote me on that. And it causes everything to precipitate out. All your iron starts to clump together. But you have to keep your pump turned off, let it settle out, and then vacuum everything up. I was ready to do that, but I was very hesitant in messing with my chemicals and everything. So I wanted to look and see if there was another method. So I came across a couple different ways that you can remove iron mechanically. The first way that I saw a lot of people doing was they were taking 5 gallon buckets, stuffing them with polyfill, which is pillow kind of stuff, and running your pump through that. So after the water passes through your pump, they would put on this 5 gallon bucket, and that would filter out some of that iron. And it seemed to work pretty well. You can watch on some of the other channels the success stories that they've had there. However, I came across a couple of different solutions in some forums. I follow trouble-free pools. So if you have a pool, check that out. And one of the things that people tried that seems to work was the sock method. So I figured, what the hell, I've got a couple of old socks. Let me see if I can get that to work before I start adding chemicals and vacuuming and everything out. I've got to say, I was pretty skeptical. I'm a pretty firm believer now in the sock method. Okay, so here's kind of what the story is. You take 3 socks of any size or shape. These have been used a couple times. These are washed out. This is how it starts, right? So you put 1 sock inside the other, and then you put the other sock over these or inside, and you get 3 socks. And then you put your hose over this. So this is the hose that returns back to your pool after it's been through your filter, okay? And you use these socks to help clean out your water. Now, with that being said, the filter does filter out some of the iron. I've had some success with that, but it also has to be constantly stirred up, and some of it will settle to the bottom, which again, you can vacuum out with your filter. But the filter only catches so much. So by doing the sock method, you're kind of creating a second filter. So this is what the socks originally start as every day, somewhat white, kind of clean socks. This is a sock from yesterday. You can see that it's actually pretty white up top, but everything else has been collected. Little debris. I'm sure some of this is dirt, but I know you can't see it really on camera, but this is that nice kind of brown iron color that you would see. And by having these 3 socks, this is the innermost sock. It actually captures quite a bit in the fibers of the cotton. The way that this essentially works, the way that I do this is, I put my 3 socks or 2 inside 1. That way I have a nice little lip here, and then I'll just take a zip tie and zip tie that on top of that. And I've got to say, I'm pretty impressed. This is my second day to do this, and the water has cleared up dramatically. It was looking better. Like I said, the filter was doing a good job of that, but it was going to take time. This really sped up that process. So if you are trying to get iron, that kind of brown color, if you're on well water, out of your pool, before you start throwing chemicals in, which they work fine, try the sock method. Now, a few words of advice. I wouldn't go any more than 3 socks. My concern with that is you're putting a lot of back pressure. If you put too much on there, too much back pressure on your pump as it's trying to force things out. I don't know what loads, I can't talk about any specific pump as to what they can actually force out, but I would just be cautious because you don't want to burn out your pump. I would not put this on the intake where it's sucking in. Again, you're going to cause your pump to work maybe a little bit too hard. But this is definitely something to work out and see if that's something that's effective for you. The other thing that I think that this might be effective on is if you have a little pool vacuum, that you might could use just a sock as your catch. So if you are using, say, a water hose suction, the bags that come on there are pretty big mesh sizes. So a lot of the finer particles you're not going to pick up. Maybe strap on a sock to it and see if that's better. The only problem with that, of course, might be trying to clean out that sock. But I mean, I've got to say that's a huge change. So I'm going to think I'm going to do it one more time today and see where we're at. But I'm very impressed by this. So if you're trying to get iron out of your pool, try the sock method, look it up, and see what other people's success stories are. This is just one of many, I'm sure. But it's at least worth a shot to see if you don't have to go spend a couple, you know, $20 or so trying to get something for your pool. All right, guys, it's been a busy, busy summer. I'll try to get more out as soon as I can. But you know, kids, they keep you busy, man. All right, guys, until next time, see ya.